ओम विष्णु पदाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी नीति नामे
नितान की श्री श्री जगन्नाथ भगवान बलदेव महाराज सुभद्रा माई सुदर्शन देव की श्री श्री लक्ष्मी नरसिंह देव अनंत देव की श्री श्री गौरताई भगवान की श्री कृष्ण जन्माष्टमी महामहोत्सव की जगत गुरु श्रील प्रभुपाद की निताई गौर प्रेमानंदे तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुर उन्मिलितम येन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। सो डू आई स्पीक इन इंग्लिश और आई एम वेरी वेरी हैप्पी। इट्स अ ग्रेट रिलीफ व्हेन यू डू हरी कथा विद डिवोटीज as compared to new people and I wish you all the best for this amazing celebration that is going on here. Next 1.5 hours or so we will transport ourselves into a realm where it is less to do with eyes and it is much more to do with the ears. I just have a small request that as far as possible just don't let your concentration waver, then you can make most of the entire Harikatha. I was born in the darkness of ignorance and my spiritual master anointed my eyes with the knowledge of Supreme Lord and I bow down to my spiritual master before I start this Krishna Katha. So when Satyuga, Lord Brahma was ordered to create the universe and create living entities in that, then there was a long process and some of you perhaps would be knowing it from the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam and third canto also, that how Lord Brahma was entrusted with the task of creating the universe. He attempted many a times first with four Kumaras who clearly declined that they are not going to be into it because they were afraid that they'll fall into Maya. And then Lord Brahma had a son from his mind. Does anyone know the name of that son who came from Lord Brahma's mind? Okay, Narad. Who else? Yes. Marichi. Have you heard of the name? Rishi Marichi? Maharishi Marichi? Okay. Maharishi Marichi was born from the mind of Lord Brahma and he had 6 sons. How many? I request devotees to not come through this because then everybody gets disturbed. I will be little stern with the arrangement because then you unknowingly commit an offense of obstructing into the listening process and breaking the concentration. Wherever you are, remain seated and just enjoy the katha, please. So Maharishi Marichi had these 6 sons and once they saw Lord Brahma doing something wrong. And when they saw that Lord Brahma was doing something wrong, they had a smirk on their face. A smirk is a kind of, you know, a sarcastic smile wherein as if you are almost saying, what are you up to? And here is our first lesson when we are beginning this Harikatha. When Lord Brahma was doing something which he should not have been doing, he was observed by these grandsons and they smiled and laughed at him and made a mockery out of him. Merely by doing that, because Lord Brahma is pure intelligence, he is like 99.99% pure intelligence. So when this episode happened by that Vaishnava offense, the six sons of Marichi glided down into the demoniac countries, and they were forced to take birth amongst demons. And they ended up being from the family of none other than Mr. Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu had how many sons? Yes. So he had four sons. And then, of course, four sons will have grandsons. And then, these six, being the demons that they were further cursed by Kalnemi that you are so horrible that you deserve to be killed by your own father. So I curse you that in one of your births you will be killed by your own father. Now I know all of you must be thinking that it's Krishna Janmashtami and Radhapati Prabhu is hovering around Maharishi Marichi and Hiranyakashipu. And now there were two very, very pious souls, beautiful souls, Sutapa and Prishni. The beauty was that for 12,000 years of demigods, they continuously performed penances and austerities, and they only used to eat fallen leaves from the trees. And like this, they were performing. And then the Supreme Lord appeared in front of them, and he said, O Sutapa and Prashni, I am so pleased with your austerities. Please ask me for a boon. But by the power of illusory energy, the couple could not ask that, O Lord, please deliver us. Instead, when Prashni looked at the beauty of the Lord, she said, all I want is a son like you. And Krishna was confused. This is just a way of saying it. He's never confused, but he said, there is no one like me. Nobody. I am the only one. If you say that you need a son like me, then it has to be me, otherwise nobody. So the couple said, okay, then you. And not once, not twice, how many times? Three times. So first time, Krishna comes as a partial expansion by the name of Prishni Garbh. Then the couple leave the body and they are reborn as Aditi and Kashyap. And once again Krishna comes as Lord Vamana and does this beautiful pastime with Maharaj Bali. And third time the Lord enters into Vasudev's heart, and from that he enters into Devaki's heart, and then he appears before them in his Chaturbhuj form. And then he said, O Devaki and Vasudev, you have forgotten that back in Satyuga you were Prashni and Sutapa, and then Aditi and Kashyap, and now Devaki and Vasudev. I have been your son two times, but this time I have appeared as the Supreme Personality of Godhead in all my glory. And this, Devaki and Vasudev, is going to be your last life. After this, you're going back to Godhead. But here is the important question. How many of you mothers and Prabhus want a child like Krishna? Please raise your hands. Okay. How many of you want a child like Krishna? Who wants to become mother and father of Krishna? Please raise the hand. Nobody? People are embarrassed to be parents. Oh, or most of you are in Madhurya Rasa. I'll tell you what is the difficulty. Despite performing austerities for 12,000 years, if you still have to have six or seven of your children killed, That's too much to ask for. And in the middle of all of this, the key is that your trust should not waver. You're not allowed that your trust wavers. A single inconvenience and our komal shraddha wavers like this. What wrong did I do? Every Mangal Arati I attended. 25 rounds on Ekadashi. Occasionally Nirjala also. So why am I suffering? It takes a lot to claim the mercy of Krishna. Unless you are blessed by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I'll come to this aspect that how unique and how rare the mercy of Mahaprabhu is. Okay, there is a rule of the class. If two people are seen talking to each other, they'll have to pay 5,000 rupees for that temple outside. Prabhu, is there a security arrangement? Can they watch? So Narahari Prabhu is nodding, so yes. And husband and wife, if they are found talking, then it's 11,000. So now you figure out. See, these 2-3 hours, migrate yourself from the worldly affairs and deep dive into Krishna's pastimes for your own welfare. Coming back, where were we? Yes. So devotees, when they undergo trials and tribulations, Jiva Goswami says this. I don't know how many of you are aware of this. He says, sometimes Krishna puts his devotees into difficulty so that demons don't come closer to Krishna bhakti. They say, no, we don't want to do this. So much of, problem is there. So now we are beginning the Krishna katha as all of you are aware of. So Kamsa is very, very fond of Devaki as his sister. And he's so fond of her that when she is leaving along with her husband Vasudev, he chooses to become the charioteer of the couple. Extreme affection. And then in the middle, he gets to hear an Akashvani. O Kamsa, know for sure that this is the same Devaki whose 8th son is going to kill you. There's a very important lesson for all of us here. Nobody is bad by heart. Nobody. But when our selfish motives collide, then the Shurpankha and Kamsa come out of us. Shurpankha had a genuine desire. She wanted a husband like Lord Ramachandra. She was not at fault. And she went and proposed. She said, you are really dashingly handsome. So I wish to marry you. And she was soft-spoken. She nicely presented herself. She hid her demoness form. This is exactly what most of us do when we deal with the external world. Please don't mind. Forgive me for the offense. And then when people don't pay heed and they do what they wish to do and they don't fulfill our desire, then the demon arises in us. In various glories, in various forms, and this demon then wants to claim that my selfish motive has to be fulfilled no matter what. So the same Kansa who was so much in love with his sister Devaki, his consciousness turned 360. Because now it was his turn. So I'll tell you a small story here. There was a conversation taking place between a spiritual master and a disciple. So this disciple was very fond of family life. So he said, oh my Gurudev, don't you think that the relationship between a mother and a son is the best possible relationship? So the spiritual master said, no. So this disciple started arguing. He said, Guru Maharaj, it is not possible. You have not understood the heart of a mother. And generally when, these over-enthusiastic disciples nag their spiritual masters, they don't respond only. So one day, The spiritual master and the disciple were standing on the bank of a river, and it was heavily raining, and the disciple saw that a she monkey was sitting holding her child, you know, under her belly. And the disciple became overwhelmed, and he said, Guru Maharaj, just look at that. She is suffering but not letting her child suffer. This is what is the love of a mother is. So the spiritual master nods. He said, yes. And then the water level rises, and the she monkey jumps further. And the disciple says, Guru Maharaj, are you seeing it? All the trouble that she is taking is for herself, to protect the child. So the Guru says, let's keep on watching. So the she monkey reaches on the top branch, and the water level continues to rise, and it reaches up to her neck. So when that happens, she takes out the child and puts the child on her head. And this disciple cries. He said, Guru Maharaj, was I not correct? He said, just keep on watching. And then the water level hits the nose of the she monkey. And the next activity that she does is she puts the child down and stands up on him, so that she can safeguard herself. This is the bitter truth of material world. We don't want to face this truth. Deep down our hearts, this truth rules the entire space of our heart. We are cordial, full of etiquettes, continuing with our envy towards Krishna and his devotees. Exactly the same thing happened with Kamsa. He went through this transformation right after just one Akashvani. Young boys and girls, you know, they say, I love you and I can die for you and I can do 1,000 things for you. Nothing happens. You can't. What can we do? What capability do we have? Nothing. The path to the husband's heart goes through his stomach. Satyabhama asked to Draupadi, she said, please let us know, how have you become so qualified that all the 5 Pandavas are completely under your control? And Draupadi responded, she said, I have won them by service. Husbands are very happy on left side. When you talk about them, they are like, you know, good. There's other side of it also, but so this transformation of heart because of our own selfish nature, it pushed Kamsa to behave in a demoniac way. Now comes the second lesson. Vasudev came for the protection of his good wife. As a Kshatriya, if you see somebody making an attempt to kill your wife, you would fight with that person. Vasudev did not do that. He in fact praised Kamsa. He said, do you realize who you are? And who is she? Not just your sister, but also a poor woman. Poor in the sense that she is not physically as strong as you are. And then I am Vasudev. I have never lied. So I promise you that the 8th son of my wife, I will come and personally hand him over to you. And Kamsa agreed. So much so that every time when we have a child, I will come and hand him over to you. After 1 year, Smara was born. Vasudev took him. Till then, they were not put into jail. Here comes the power of bad association. When the first child was given, Kamsa thought, what harm can he cause? Akashvani said, it's going to be the 8th one. So he said, no, why should I kill? Please understand the heart of Kamsa also. He's not enjoying the process the way we saw in Mahabharata serial. No, it's heavy on the heart to kill your nephew. Even for Kamsa. See, the way we have been brought up is when somebody shows us the bad side, they take it to extreme. When somebody shows us the good side, they take it to the another extreme. That's not the complete truth. We must understand, when Kamsa was doing it, there was anxiety in him. He was hurt to be doing it against his own sister. And then when he got into the association of his all his ministers, it is they who said, "My dear Kamsa, if the first son kills you? We cannot depend on this Akashvani. And if you keep them free, you would never know. They will send the kid somewhere and you may not come to know. Welcome to Kusanga." And then he put them into jail. Someone like Vasudev, whose character is so clean, whose presence of mind is so tremendous, and someone like Devaki, who is completely sinless, they had to undergo such a tribulation of getting their small children killed one after another. And then they are being kept in jail constantly, 8 years. There was no Supreme Court at that time. No bail, no parole, everything there only. So the six sons who Kalnemi had cursed, one after another, they came into the womb of Devaki. And because Vasudev took them to Kamsa, so this is how the curse became true, that you will be killed by your own father. Because Vasudev arranged for it. But these six, they denote Kaam, Krodh, Mad, Lobh, Moh and Matsarya. So those of you who desire to become parents of Krishna, please know for sure that first these six will be killed completely, and the seventh would be your spiritual master who will come. And he will keep the whole place clean. And then the eighth one, Shri Krishna Chandra Bhagavan Ki. Then Hari arises. He comes. Now how many of us want to be the proud parents of Krishna? Anybody? Prabhu still wants. Yo yatha mam prapadyante tamas tathaiv bhajamyaham. The proportion in which you surrender to me, then I also surrender to you in the same proportion. So the Krishna appears before Devaki and Vasudev. He reminds them who he is, who they were. And then he becomes a little child. And here begins our third point. Devaki once again comes under the influence of material energy. Not material energy, but yoga maya. And she again thinks, yes, he was Chaturbhuj Narayan, but Kamsa is very powerful. This is the power of illusory energy. You have Supreme Personality of Godhead as your charioteer and you can still get confused. Arjuna heard Bhagavad Gita from none else than Krishna himself, and still he became confounded and bewildered time and again. Daivi hai isha gunamai mama maya duratyaya. Arjuna, it is very difficult to surmount. Mameva ye prapadyante maya mitam tarantite. Those who surrender unto me, they cross this. But we are seeing Krishna's associates doing this pastime, that they are bewildered. Not to talk of us. And then Vasudev takes Krishna. The gates open automatically, which all of you like, and when we see it on a television set, it's very good to see. But I wish to draw your attention to something else. Vasudev is anxious that before sun rises, I have to return to Mathura. I need to drop this child to Vrindavan. And then on top of that anxiety, it rains. Suppose you have to step out for some important assignment and it rains. What is our first reaction? Oh, and then it's raining cats and dogs so heavily. And then you figure out that there is this pure devotee who wants to have association of Lord Krishna, and that's why Vasudev has been put into this trouble. Who is that pure devotee? Jamuna Maharani ki. Now she is on a separate trip. She said, Krishna is coming. I need to rise up so much at least that I touch his lotus feet. Devotees are so romantic that they can put anybody in trouble. Vasudev is, you know, water is going in his nostrils, is somehow managing Krishna. Krishna also just took out a little bit of his lotus feet just for Jamuna's pleasure. And then once the water drops touch, then the water level subsides, Vasudev crosses. With one activity, Krishna satisfies many, unlimited, optimal utilization of resources. The Lord Hari, the best CEO we have ever known. So many he is satisfying parallelly. And then what happens? Krishna reaches, Jasoda Mai is super duper tired on that particular day because of pregnancy. And because of Yogmaya's influence, she is under deep sleep. And then a divine exchange offer takes place. Swapping. Yogmaya reaches to Devaki and Krishna reaches to Jasoda. Now the Lord is in his own abode. He is in Vrindavan. Shri Vrindavan Dham ki, Shri Krishna Balaram ki. Jasoda wakes up and then she figures out that she has become a mom to a baby boy. Now some interesting pastimes. Once Jasoda Mai was beating Krishna. One slap on one cheek and another slap on another cheek. Seeing this, Lord Balaram became very upset. See, Lord's associate, they come and join the Lord for the pastimes, but they don't know who they are until and unless they see Lord Krishna in trouble. So when Dasharath told Ramachandra to go to the forest, then Lakshman became upset with Dasharath. And he said, this old man, you know, he has gone berserk. He simply loves his wife and because of a woman, he is doing it to you, my lord. And Lord Ramachandra scolds him back. You should watch your words, Lakshman. He is our father. But devotees do not care because they love Krishna most. So the same thing happened here. So Balaram shouted at Jasoda Mai. And how old? 3-4 years old. And Balaram said, Maya, you don't know who he is. And she was taken by surprise. Okay, you tell me who he is. He is the same Supreme Personality of Godhead. She said, which? He said, who killed Hiranyakashipu? He is that Narsimhadev. And Mother Jasoda looks at that little, the tiny child. I said, oh, okay. And he's the same Ramachandra who killed the 10-headed Ravana. She once again has a deep look at Krishna, you know. She said, all right. And this time he has come as Krishna. She said, who are you? He said, I am that 1,000-headed on whose head the unlimited universes lie just like a mole. And I am the same Lakshman. And she slapped him. Kadak. She said, all the incarnations had to come in my home only. First Narsimhadev came and then Ramachandra came and now Krishna came and then... Krishna tells Yogamaya, oh Yogamaya, I love my Vrindavan so much that when I am with my devotees, you please cover me so that I forget my godliness, my supreme controller tendency. And then I wish to exchange the rasas with my devotees. And that's exactly what is happening. The Lord is being beaten by Mother is being beaten by Mother Yashoda, and Balaram ji is not liking the whole thing. So one time Balaram became envious. It can't happen, but he does. Transcendentally, anything can happen. He said, "Boss, why is it that everybody says Krishna is so good? And if that is the case, then I also want to become Krishna." So Rohini tried to pacify, but Balaram was in no mood to get pacified. So she said, he said, "I need to be colored black." So they put a color on him. He said, "Now I need a peacock feather." They put a peacock feather on him. He said, "How am I looking? Am I looking like Krishna?" She said, "Yes." Then Balaram thought that if two Krishnas are there, then also there is a problem. So he said, "This little one will not go today. Only I will go to the forest." All right. Now Balaram steps out and Gopas see and he said, "There's something wrong today. Krishna's height all of a sudden and he looks a little strong also. Looks like Krishna, but there is..." Then the older gopis saw, they were also wondering, you know, he's growing very fast all of a sudden. The young gopis figured out, he said, "No, this is not our hero. He's somebody else." Balaram reaches forest and a demon attacks him. And Balaram kicks the demon and the demon dies. "Beta, sit down." Then after 10 minutes, second demon comes. Balaram kills him. In 1 hour, 12 demons come. Balaram kills all of them. After 8 hours shift, Balaram returns home. And he just throws that peacock feather. He said, "Tomorrow I am not going. You know, the whole day I can't be doing this stupid thing of killing this and killing that and killing this. So you go." The beauty of Krishna is that he can kill somebody, at the same time he can accept prasadam from a mother, and at the same time he can play with his friends like nothing happened. Isn't it remarkable? Everything with great intensity, with great perfection, and with immaculate precision. Not a tiny bit here or there. He does things in such a way. So this way the two brothers are growing up. Where? In Vrindavan. They're having their own little fights and so on. And so I will not go into the asuras, the Vratasura and Phalanasura and all of that. I just want to tell you one small thing from there. My dear devotees, remember, even if you are in Vrindavan, there are demons. Enough to meditate for the whole day. Not to talk of material world. Even if you are in Vrindavan, there are, not in bomb Vrindavan, not there. There are demons. So what is Krishna assuring? He is assuring protection. He says in Bhagavad Gita, "Arjuna, if you follow me, then by my grace, you will overcome all the obstacles." He did not say there will be no obstacles. Watch these words carefully and then continue. So next time when you come across a difficulty, you must know that I will cross over by the grace of Lord Krishna. Don't say, "Why should there be a difficulty at all?" That is, has not been said. There are two bitter truths people don't want to face. One is this: they don't want a difficult situation. And the second is, if there is a difficult, you know, situation, then my understanding of protection is my physical protection and protection of my children and my family and my friends. Don't mind, but I have seen devotees reciting Narsing Aarti even if they lose slippers. Whereas our acharyas time and again have shown us that we pray for mercy so that we can serve Krishna more. So the meaning of protection is, oh my Lord, I should not forget you under all the circumstances that you are preparing for me. So the actual protection is not forgetting Krishna. That's the only protection that we need. Everything else will be fine. When I'm seeing the live example of Guru Maharaj, you know, I'm talking about my spiritual master, and some of you, my God brothers and God sisters, are here, of His Holiness Jayaprata Goswami. I'm seeing him actually transcending the bodily platform already and connected with Mahaprabhu, such an intimate connectivity that he doesn't come back on bodily platform. It amazes me. I have acknowledged it in front of him also. I said, I can't fathom, where do you start from? And how can somebody tolerate so much of pain just because you know that some of us are lazy and you want us to go a little close to Krishna. That's all. So next time when you ask for the word protection, please do ask that, oh Krishna, I should not forget you under all the conditions. The most beautiful example is when Yudhishthir Maharaj was going to the forest along with his brother and Draupadi, Yudhishthir cried. So Krishna asked Yudhishthir, what happened to you? Why did you cry? What is the difficulty? Are you afraid that you will go into the forest and there will be inconveniences? He says, no, my Lord, no. But not a single sadhu has ever gone back from Yudhishthir's door. And now I don't know, because I have no means of livelihood. How will we survive? And in the middle of that, if some sadhu comes and if I cannot feed him, I will not be able to tolerate that. That's when Akshay Patra came to Draupadi. So for one full sitting, she could cook unlimited amount. But where is the focus of Yudhishthir? That's the beauty. Look at devotee's focus, you know. Some of you are chanting parallelly. I request you to not chant because it won't get counted in any, neither in chanting nor in katha. Please don't mind. You know, these rounds need to get finished. I understand this pain. And on Janmashtami, there are too many services, so there are... Should I tell you this interesting pastime and then we'll go back? So there was this temple president in London. He was organizing Haribol. He was organizing a Rath Yatra. And he had really tough time finishing his 16 rounds. So he went and had a fight with Jagannath. He said, you tell me honestly, how do you expect me to do it? The team is very lean. Everybody needs direction from me. And Prabhupada said the 16 rounds have to happen. And this Rath Yatra is tomorrow. And I have no mechanism. Till today I have managed somehow. But tomorrow morning everybody would ask me every second minute, how do I finish these 16 rounds? What is this? Either you reduce the service or do something about it. So next day the Rath Yatra started. Little after the afternoon, the police came because somebody complained that they are making too much noise. So they said, we will not disturb the yatra, but we will, you know, take away the temple president. Now the temple president is behind the bars. Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Once, after a couple of hours, 16 rounds were done, the cop said, go and don't do it next time. And he was like, out. So your prayers do get answered, but in the way Krishna wants. And intimate prayers definitely get answered. So we must know what we pray and the consequences of it. Then comes the next stage where the tough time comes. The two brothers are supposed to leave Braj and leave for Mathura. Vrindavan tyajyanti padam ekam na gachyati. Oh, Radhike, I don't leave Vrindavan, not even for a second. Not even a little bit outside. My Vasudeva, as my expansion, will go to Mathura. I will be here. But a day prior to that, Krishna goes to Srimati Radharani and he tells her that tomorrow, when I will be leaving, my parents would be crying. Yashoda Maya will faint time and again because of separation. Nanda Baba would be completely dejected and crestfallen, and gopis would be crying, and they would hold me to not go and plead at my feet. But to ensure that I fulfill my own dharma, Radhike, I will go. But I wish to make a request to you. Tomorrow when I see you, I don't want to see you crying. Because if you cry, then I'm afraid that I might fall off. And that compassion personified, that service personified Srimati Radharani, when the Lord Hari was leaving Braj, she just gaped at him for long and long. Didn't utter a word, didn't shed a drop of tear. And Krishna left Vrindavan. Sridhama is holding Kadamba tree, embracing the Kadamba tree and crying and talking to the Kadamba tree, and he says, oh Kadamba, don't cry, don't cry. He never fulfilled his promises earlier also. So he has left, so let him leave. But I am assuring you, you don't cry. So the Kadamba responds. He said, fine, I will not cry, but you tell me, why are you crying? Vrindavan is no more the same Vrindavan. Krishna increased the pleasure of Brajavasis 10 times by giving him or putting them into separation. Before we go further, Lord performs a beautiful pastime in the Krishna book. Prabhupada describes it very, very elaborately, of killing the Kaliya. Krishna climbs on the tree, pulls up his dhoti, and then, you know, he hits his thigh 2 times as if preparing. And then he jumps. All of that is fine. But on the bank of Jamuna, people are fainting, thinking that little boy trying to kill such a huge snake. And they were very sure that Krishna will die today. But there were some damsels of Vraja who wanted their hero to dance on a platform which is most unique in the world. Vasudeva is having a very tough time. Jamunaji still wants to touch the feet of Krishna. All Brajavasis are having a very tough time, and Krishna is becoming a hero. Imagine the perfection the Lord has. Every hood that raises up, the Lord puts his foot only on that. And still he creates a rhythm out of it. And there's a pattern and there is a dance happening because some ladies wanted it. Multiple things he satisfies by one activity. The kind of love that the Lord has. Bhajay vrajayak mandanam samasta papakhandanam supuch kuch mastakam sunada venu hastakam ananda rang sagaram namami Krishna nagaram. He is the ocean of bliss. But then he provides that bliss to his dear devotees. So the Lord moves, reaches Mathura and comes across another damsel. Her name is Kubja. He straightens her up and puts her into her old, the previous beauty. But the takeaway from that pastime is, the moment she becomes proper, she flirts with Hari, none else. She says, let's go to my room. And Krishna responds like a statesman. He says, yes, you are very right. People like me who have left their homes, it's only ladies like you who are their rescue. And he this way satisfies Kubja and sends her back and never goes, of course, there. But what we learn from this is, when we are under difficulty, it's easy to serve. It's easy to chant. And then when we regain our old glory, then we flirt with Krishna. Bhaktivinoda Thakur confirms every asura is a representative of an anartha. So every pastime, whether it's of Lord Chaitanya or Lord Krishna, there are takeaways. If you have your list of takeaways, it helps. I'm not asking you to write, I'm just saying it. Krishna goes into the arena where the fight is going on, and Chanur and Mushtik are there. Chanur was so powerful that he could crash hills, large hills. He was so powerful. So when he looked at Krishna and Balaram, he said, you know, you two, by my one slap, you will be killed. Once again, some women of Mathura were looking at the two young boys, and the young boys had to reciprocate. And this time Krishna comes and claims. How many of you are fond of Rajini dialogues? Raise your hands. So, Krishna says, and he shouts at Chanur. He said, you fool, even if I raise my eyebrow a little, unlimited universes gets killed. That's my power. And all the women folk are going, ah. Come again, Krishna. This is so heartwarming. He fulfills the... Okay, how many of us ever meditate after eating? That, okay, now that I have eaten, carbohydrates are getting segregated and vitamin is getting segregated and B-positive blood is going in this. Does anyone do it? Who does it? Sorry? Who does it? Who releases the acid in the stomach? Vaishvana, yes. So, we only eat, he digests. Just think, Prabhus and mothers, when you sleep, who wakes up? There is no guarantee. Sometimes we think that if we don't think, the world will not exist. You don't think 6 to 8 hours every day and the world continues. In fact, your body also continues better if you sleep. I asked this doctor friend of mine, he's a cardiologist, he was showing me one CD. And so I asked him, I said, just tell me one thing. Where is this dhak dhak coming from? He said, beside this, ask anything. I said, leave it, I don't need. Arjuna, hridadeshe tishthati. I stay where? Sit down. I stay inside the heart. We never remember whether the heart is palpitating or not. But Krishna is constantly serving me, you, everybody. Each one of us is being served by Lord Krishna. Shri Shri Jagannath Baldev Subhadrama Ike. Each one of us. In fact, in third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, when four Kumaras reach to the abode of Lord Vishnu, when he comes, he says, his first statement is, I have become God by serving Brahmanas like you. sometimes these, you know, these materially afflicted people, they say, all the time, why should we chant? And I feel like saying, if all the time Krishna doesn't serve you, your heartbeat would stop then and there. And he never says, why should I keep your heart going? While the Titanic song may continue. Those of you who got the joke can laugh. And my heart will. It can't go on without Krishna's mercy. No matter who you are. So this way, finally Lord drags Kamsa. But this time, he plays the role of a son. See, most of our movies, you know, they are twisted versions of Vedic culture. Contaminated versions of Vedic culture. So when Dharmendra takes a vow in a standard Bollywood film of 80s, he said, I will kill. Whoever has killed you, I will kill. This time when Krishna is punching Kamsa, he says, you put my parents into jail. You gave them so much torture. I will kill you now. But all the facial gestures of Krishna are so full of anger, and he by his fists kill him just to prove a point that my mother and my father, you please be satisfied because I have scored it now. It's even. The Lord migrates to Dwarka. Satyabhama, Rukmani, Jamavanti are discussing amongst themselves, is there a way that we can keep Krishna happy? Is there a way that Krishna somehow forgets Vrindavan? When he goes to sleep, his pillow is wet because of his tears. The bedsheet is wet because of his tears. So much so that sometimes even the floor is wet. And all he does is, in his dreams, he shouts the name of his Gopa friends. Or he shouts, oh Jamune, come closer. Or else he will keep on shouting, Radhike, where are you? They meditate on all the possible attempts to try and keep Krishna happy. So once Krishna decides to make them taste the flavor of Braj, so he flirts with Rukmani ji. He says, Rukmani, you know, there is no proof that I am a Kshatriya. Then I am a womanizer also. I have flirted with so many. I am maintaining so many wives. You are the sister, the proud sister of a Kshatriya family. And on top of it, you know, I steal things. So there is nothing good about my conduct. So you should leave me. Krishna was hankering for a reciprocation, something which is similar to Radharani's reciprocation. But because Rukmani ji is in Dasya Bhav, so she started becoming super apprehensive. She thought, I must have committed a blunder. He now wants to give up on me. And my Lord will leave me because there is an error in my service. So when Krishna says like this, Rukmani ji faints. And Krishna cries. He says, Radhike, there is nobody like you who can satisfy me. Because had I cracked this joke with you, you would have responded with an answer which would have satisfied me. Rukmani could not. There's a difference between Dwarkadhish and Vrindavan Krishna. And our movement is for Dwarkadhish or Vrindavan Krishna? How many for Dwarkadhish? Raise your hands. Oh. How many for Braj? We are only concerned with the first 13 years. The remaining 112, we don't want. In Kurukshetra, Krishna returns as a king, and Brajvasis also reach hearing that Krishna has come to Kurukshetra. It's close by, you know, both are, one is in UP, one is in Haryana. So they, it's it, you can go 120 kilometers. So they go there. And then Srimati Radharani sees Krishna. And she doesn't recognize him. And the gopis remind her, they said, this is your Krishna. She said, no, he isn't. He's a king, he's a majestic king. With the helmet on, you know, and a crown and all these necklaces. And my Krishna, he only puts on a peacock feather. Krishna is crying hearing this. And Radharani is genuine when she's saying that, I don't recognize him. So though the Lord moved out of Vrindavan, but he's always relishing the separation. And now comes the most interesting part of Krishna Leela, which is Mahabharata. A lot of teachings are there which you can take out from this section. The first, how many of you have heard of Jayadrath? So Arjun takes a vow. Wow. Which is that by tomorrow sunset, if I don't kill Jayadrath, I will enter fire. And Krishna doesn't respond. He said, okay. The takeaway is, think twice before you take a vow. And consult your authority before you take a vow. And something that Arjuna couldn't do because he was overwhelmed by the loss of his son. So another takeaway is, when the situations are difficult, make sure you don't take a vow. No. It's 5:30. Sun is about to set. Arjun says, oh Krishna, quickly take my chariot in front of Jayadrath so that I can kill him before sunset. Krishna says, hold on. It's a break time for me. And he gets down from the chariot with some wheat. And he places it before the horse. And horse and Krishna both are very calm. And Arjuna is super anxious. He says, boss, this dinner can happen tomorrow also. Even if this horse fasts today, he will not die. But if you don't reach there, then I am going to serious. Now, that's... At that moment, Krishna says, see, this you should have thought when you took the vow. You will be saved by your Lord, but still there will be difficulty. Safety is assured, not the process, not during. And then with aplomb and calm, the Lord sits back on the chariot, goes in front of Jayadrath, and the sun sets. And then as we see, Jayadrath says, Arjuna, get ready to enter into the fire. Arjun puts his arrow and bow aside with his head hung low. This is what I call Krishnastic. Each one of you has this experience. Krishna puts us through difficulty, down, 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 then we give up hope. Then he says, you know, no, don't give up hope. I'm there. Tuck. And then again, down, down, down. How many of you have experience? Please raise your hands. The naughty Lord, I can't help it. He does this. He does it to each one of us. That's how we get purified. That's how we love him more. Lord Shiva always is so keen that when he got bewildered by Mohini, he tells, oh Uma, look at the power of my Lord. I am one of his main potencies and still he could bewilder me. And in a matter of a second. And he feels proud. And we also feel proud. Our life, our oxygen is the reciprocation from Krishna. Why are you spending so much time here otherwise? Every morning, who likes? But we know that when he will reciprocate, then there will be fun. So we undergo this austerity. And then they say, now read Bhagavatam. Then we under... One Acharya says, Krishna is like a drug peddler. Initially, he gives it for free. You don't know what you are getting into. So these brahmacharis, when they go out and, you know, grab these youth forum kids, he says, chant Hare Krishna just once. and come for feast. It's all about dancing and eating. And he comes. Little does he know, once he comes before Jagannath, gone for life. After that, whatever happens is drudgery, is hankering, is austerity and infamy. Because family members keep on nagging us. What has gone wrong with you? You don't know what's wrong with me. I can't explain what's wrong with me. What do you get when you go to the temple? Don't ask. I don't know, seriously. But if I don't go, then I also don't like, so I want to go to the temple. Once this angry father came to Gopal Krishna Maharaj and he said, you know what? My son is living here and I have told him, once he gets old and retired, then he can come and do this bhakti and all. But why are you leaving, you know, killing his productivity right now? Maharaj said, no problem. You take your son back. I just have a simple proposal. Now that you are retired, you stay and let the son go. So the fellow left. It's very uncertain when we will leave this body. So when these brahmacharis, they go out and preach and make these conditioned souls chant the name of Lord Krishna, they are doing a great service. Because even if you have chanted a little, there is very high probability that while leaving your body, you may remember Krishna. That's the kind of service that preachers do. Krishna confirms, you may be a pujari, you may be a cook, you may be a cleaner, you may be a katha vachak, but of all, he likes those who spread his glories. So, Bhurida Jana, they are the most compassionate and generous ones who are going and bringing the conditioned souls here. So, the drug peddler, what he does is, first time he gives you free. After a while, he doesn't turn up. Then after 1 week, he comes and you say, want to taste more? Yeah, I don't mind it. And then you take a little bit of, and a high comes. Third time, he comes after a month and you ask, you did not turn up, where have you been? And then you say, you know what, this drug these days, I have to, transport in, and there's some money involved in it. I'm not asking for my profit, but at least. So with a heavy heart, he gives 10 rupees and takes the drug. Gradually, he raises the price. So you begin with one round. They give you nice story. You will become crorepati in 1 year and 2 years and all of that. Then 1 to 4. Then 4 to 8. Then 8 to 16. Then 16 to temple. Surrender. When Draupadi's Chirharan was going on, she went to everyone. First she went to her husbands, then she went to the king, then she went to the lawmakers. Nobody helped. Then she decided that she will help herself. This is the phenomenon by which modern mindset is suffering. I will help myself. So she puts both her hands like this. And then on top of that, she says, Krishna, save me. Krishna doesn't come. Then she holds her pallu by one hand and still keeps one hand on top. And then she says, Krishna, please help me. And Krishna doesn't come. Then she figures out that now there is no chance, absolutely no chance. Then she lets both of her hands go. She says, I will see whatever happens. She raises both her hands and she says, Krishna, please come. This is the time when polyester comes for the rescue, or chiffon, or whatever it is. The lesson is, the surrender has to be 100% complete to claim the 100% mercy. Partial surrender won't take us far. So when you become overly intelligent and you say, yeah, Krishna is there, but there is a big but always. And this but stops us from going closer to Krishna. Krishna bhakti is not about discipline. No, it is not. Sadhana bhakti maybe, yes. It is about intensity. It is about lalyam with which the devotees serve. We prefer satoguna as compared to rajo and tamo, but at the same time, we don't care if there is Janmashtami, we will sleep at 1 and wake up at 4 with a lot of acid in our stomach and with groggy eyes and with a heavy head, because it is our Lord's appearance day. We will undergo this austerity. I don't want to live only for the sake of living. Arjuna, those who become bounded by the mode of goodness, they always meditate on comfort and knowledge. So even satoguna, all this pranayam and all the meditations that you have heard will only give you long age, comfortable living. It will not give you love of God. What happens when you take Rath Yatra? You very well know that there will be joy in the heart. Mahaprabhu said, Krishna Bhakt Bada Chatur. Don't think that you are some very big dani who is doing it for Krishna. We all are doing it for ourselves. Because we want that drop of mercy, that drop of nectar, which is sweeter than anything else in this material world. So Krishna removes the veil, the sun appears again, and then with a sense of pride, Lord says, Arjun, thok de. He is putting demons also into bewilderment. He said, ye kya hua? How come? The intimacy continues. Like a father, like an expert teacher, he is teaching Arjuna. At the same time, he is ensuring that he should win. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna. Wherever there is Yogeshwar Krishna and wherever there is Arjuna, all three things are there. Similar thing happens when Karna is, he gets down from his chariot and he's busy taking his wheel out of the earth. And Lord looks at Arjun, who is waiting for Karna to come back on his chariot. This is Arjun. Each one of us has this component. Devotees are by nature soft. They are by nature afraid of breaking the law. And then Krishna says, what are you waiting for? Kill him. Arjun, no, I can't break the rule. He doesn't have any bow, arrow, any, and he's off his chariot. And Krishna is like, do you know when they killed your son Abhimanyu, he was also weaponless. And there was no one-to-one fight. They congregated and killed him. So who broke the rule first, Arjun? So Arjun said, they broke the rule first. So they say, Krishna said, then there is no harm. Kill him. And when Arjuna is ready to kill, Karna doesn't argue back with Arjun. He argues with Krishna. He says, you, religion personified. You are the supreme personality. You are sitting here. How can it happen? And Krishna says, tu bol raha hai. Abhimanyu ko marte hue samajh mein nahi aayi thi. And with again the same sense of pride, Krishna says, thok de. And Arjuna kills. And in the middle of all of this, where there are countless dead bodies and blood and everything, there is one romantic person called Bhishma Pita. He is busy gaping and looking at Krishna's beauty. As the dust from the hoofs of the horses rise and go on top of Lord Hari's hair, they become all the more beautiful. And then there are drops of perspiration on his forehead, and the face becomes all the more enchanting. And Bhishma Pitama is drinking the nectar of Krishna's beauty while people are dying. And they are crying. And they are wailing. Now you see, devotees can relish at any moment. They don't wait for opportune time to come. Any time. And then Bhishma Pitamah says, I have heard that you took a vow that you will not pick up any weapons. Now what will you do? Look at the confidence that Bhishma Pitamah has. Prabhupada confirms that Bhishma Pitamah could take care of 25,000 Arjunas at one time. He was so powerful. And when Bhishma Pitamah started attacking Arjuna, Arjuna had no choice. And when Krishna saw that my devotee and my disciple is now going to get killed, Lord jumped from the chariot, took the wheel out, and was about to kill when Arjun became very, very upset. He said, if because of me, my spiritual master and my Lord receives infamy, then I have no right to live. So he jumps and holds Krishna by his waist. And he said, Lord, don't do it. Let him kill me, but you don't break your vow. He said, Krishna said, no, he cannot kill you. I can't let him kill, even if I have to break my vow. And then Bhishma Pitamah says, dekha, tod diya na promise. I mean, they are completely unconscious of what is going on. They're always busy in, you know, with their Lord. One of the 64 qualities where Krishna is unique is he has bhakta madhurya with his devotees, always with his devotees. And this bhakta madhurya he enjoys. So Prabhupada says Krishna never likes to be alone. So some of these outside people, they say, I only want to have Krishna's darshan. I said, you can't. You'll have to see Govardhan, Jamunaji, Gop, Nanda Baba, Jasoda. It's a whole entourage that will come. It's a package deal. It can't come like this. Krishna becomes pacified when Bhishma Pitamah drops his weapons and then Krishna throws that wheel from Uttar Pradesh all the way to West Bengal. When Lord does things, he does it like that. He threw it from which state? UP to West Bengal. And casually. And that place we know as Ek Chakra Dham Ki, Shriman Nityananda Ram Ki. How casually? Effortless. That's how Krishna does things. Next, Mahabharata goes on and Gandhari shouts on Hari. She said, I can clearly see that all of this happened because of you. You conspired. While I know that you are Supreme Personality of Godhead, I curse you, Krishna, that the way my family got killed, your entire generation will get killed. The next one. Now the takeaway is, just in your mind, think of your best friend, not materially best friend. Have you thought? Now if he or she asks you for your mobile phone for a day, will you readily give without a single question? Kya karega? Itni zarurat padi. Main dusri sim dila deta hu. Main naya set leke aa jata hu. All of that will go on. Just to keep friendship with Arjuna and just to fulfill his promise, Lord let his entire generation die. This thing makes Krishna what he is. He suffers for his devotees. When 16,000 queens were kept by Bhaumasur, they got contaminated by his touch. And they said, now no one will accept us. Today, how many of us would like to accept a spouse who we very well know is contaminated, quote unquote, raped? We won't be daring enough to do it. And knowing fully well that if you have 16,000 of them, how the world will look at you. Till this day, people call Krishna a womanizer. He tolerated this insult because he gave shelter to all those 16,000. This makes Lord Hari, Lord Hari. His willingness to suffer for his devotees. No, never mind. Carry on. Just a small pastime that came, so I'm just narrating it. Generally, I don't. I once was asked by Guru Maharaj, he said, how do you feel after initiation? So I told him, I said, I feel blissful and I feel very light, like a cotton flowing in the air. And then my next statement was that I said, but sometimes I wound you because my conduct is not perfect. And then he just held my hand and just shook me, as if assuring me that don't mind, it's okay. I'm ready to suffer because I see you are trying to come on a right platform. Krishna is willing to suffer. His devotees are willing to suffer. Even till this date, when you go down and bow down to Prabhupada, a section of your karma goes to him and he also suffers. Je anilo prem dhan karuna prachur. Too much compassion. That's when it happens. So service means inconvenience. Service means taking pain. Service means suffering. And if you are willing to do that, then welcome to Krishna consciousness. It's not about stylish bead bags, great new shikha ponies, fancy kurtas, and all what you have, and your gadgets. People think that they chant and, you know, go through Veda base, it makes them qualify for a devotee. It is all external, all external. In Mayapur, there was once, during the Navdeep Mandal Parikrama, one brahmachari drowned in Ganga. And then others jumped and rescued him out of the river. And then he became all of a sudden very, very silent, whereas he used to be very jovial. So his brahmachari friends asked, they said, what happened to you? Why have you gone so silent ever since that incident? So he opened up. He said, when I was drowning and I became certain that this is my last breath before I go unconscious, the only picture that came in front of my eyes was of that little girl under the shower. And then I became fainted. After 10 years of brahmachari life, towards the end of my life, all I could think of was on that little girl. How many of you have seen that advertisement? Raise your hands. Yeah. Dhyayato vishayan pumsah sangateshu. Come on, recite the shlokas. You all are devotees. Sangat sanjayate kamah, kamat krodha abhijayate, krodhat bhavati sammohan smriti vibhramah, smriti bhranshad buddhinasho, buddhinashad pranashyati. And then this devotee cried and he said, Krishna gave me a second chance. I better focus on my rounds. It can't be external. It has to be internal. It has to be closely in connection with Krishna. It's Prabhupada confirms, too much austerity makes the heart hard. So it's not about performing austerities. It is about feeling connected and then serving. O Jagannath, 3 new people came to the temple today and I facilitated their coming and going back as my token of service to you. Please accept it. You don't need any other approval. You rendered service, service got accepted, you will get your reward in due course of time. This way, keep on serving. Coming back to Krishna Katha, the Mahabharata episode gets over, the Lord allows, and after that, Ganga comes with all the rivers to Krishna. And she says, Lord, now that you are planning to move back, what is the order for us? So Krishna says, O Gange, for next 5,000 years, you will have to take the sins of countless conditioned souls. But don't be dejected. After that, my devotees will come. And when they will bathe in you, then all your sinful reactions will go away. Vaishnava Bhakta Vrinda ki. When you all take bath in Ganges, you purify Ganges. Nobody believes me. That's the power. And then, after the 125 years of his stay on this Dhara Dham, the Lord performs the last pastime and settles once again the law of karma of what he did during Ramachandra's incarnation when Bali was killed. You know, the Lord had to kill him while he was hiding. And the same thing happens and Krishna migrates to his abode. There are two or three pastimes specific after which I will, you know, stop this katha here. The first is Krishna has four qualities which makes him better than Lord Narayana. One of them is Roop Madhurya. So here is an assignment for all of you. Kindly think of your favorite actor or actress. Don't speak his or her name in your mind. Are you ready? Husbands don't have to tell wives and vice versa. Now, just think, how long can you look at that person? How long? Without eating. Without sleeping. When Krishna lifted Govardhan, for 7 days and seven nights, Brijvasis did not eat. They did not sleep. All the Lord had to do is just smile. And this smile was so enchanting and so beautiful that they kept on looking and gazing and gaping at Krishna for 7 continuous days. That's what you call beauty. Can there be somebody who is as beautiful? Okay, who is stronger, Krishna or Radharani? Okay, I know you will not say the name. So, for those who are for Radharani, please raise your hands. Today is Krishna's birthday, come on. Those for Krishna, raise your hands. So, this conversation started between Lord Hari and Srimati Radharani. Who is stronger? So, Srimati Radharani said, Prabhu, I can enhance the ocean of bliss which you derive out of my service unlimitedly. So Krishna says, Radhike, I can measure it. So Radharani says, by the time you measure it, I will further increase it. Krishna says, I can again measure it. Radharani said, I can again increase it. Since time immemorial, the competition is going on. Srimati Radharani ki. Krishna goes past another Roop Madhurya, looks at his reflection in Dwarka in one of the pillars. How many of you understand Hindi? So mujhe kyun angrezi bulwa rahe? So he looks at his own reflection. He said, yaar, main to gajab sundar hoon. I'm dashing, man. I look so good. And the Lord became enchanted by his own beauty. And then he started thinking. He said, these gop sakhas, they look at this beautiful face of mine for so many long hours and they drink the nectar of my beauty with their eyes. Why can't I have that pleasure? I'm so unfortunate. Thinking like this, Krishna became depressed. So depression is not just in material world, it happens up there also. Then he thought of these older gopis. He said, how fortunate. They make me dance and then they look at me and then they derive the relish which I don't know how it feels. How good does it feel? He become further depressed. Then he thought of young gopis. He says, they had the chance to touch me even. How much more bliss they would have derived. And Krishna's depression became severe. And then he thought, what kind of a pleasure does Radha derive? And the depression reached its peak and Krishna became angry. And he shouted, he said, Radhike! And Srimati Radharani appeared before Hari and she bowed down and she said, yes. So he said, why do you exist? So Srimati Radharani says, I exist for your pleasure, my lord. So do you see that I am happy right now? She says, no. So then why don't you die? Humility personified, service personified, Srimati Radharani humbly backs off and starts melting. And when she was melting, it was all like a molten gold. And Krishna mistakenly thought, this is that element which gives them the pleasure. So like a robber, he jumped onto that, he held it, and he pushed it deep inside his heart. Thinking that this way, he can experience what Srimati Radharani experiences. Little did the master of universe know that this time he is against someone superior. The black color changed because of the molten gold. And as the bhava entered, Krishna forgot that he is Krishna. And then he started shouting his own names. And that most enchanting form of Lord Hari is none other than Shri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Ki, Sriman Gauranga Mahaprabhu Ki. It is that unique avatar which has given us mercy, because of which deriving bliss out of Krishna Bhakti has become possible. All glories to Prabhupada, all glories to Vaishnava Acharyas who have so kindly given us this process. So Mahaprabhu came in the mood and body complexion of Srimati Radharani. So this way, the shloka from Srimad Bhagavad Gita, which is Sarva Dharman, Radharani said, who will follow all these rules in Kali Yuga? Who can leave dharma, all dharmas? Dharma of a mother, dharma of a professor, dharma of a teacher, dharma, not possible. But when Lord Chaitanya came, no condition. No condition. Just chant and, yeah. The Dwarka temple president, a good friend of mine, Namog Leela Prabhu, he says, chant, suffer and be happy. There's a little bit of austerity in doing it. So today, when you think of Yogeshwar Krishna, please think of him as someone who is difficult to obtain. Think of him as someone who can still be obtained only by the mercy of Sriman Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his associates and his followers like Srila Prabhupada and the present acharyas in our society. When you think of Krishna, get ready to have so many sons and daughters and God knows what not killed inside you. Get ready, all of that will happen. Pandavas never remained happy, no for sure. They had to suffer. Bhishma Pitama says, you would have certainly died had Dharma not been on your side, had Brahmanas not been on your side, and had Krishna himself not been on your side. So difficulties will come. But we will overcome those difficulties by taking shelter of Lord Krishna.